Today in the news, Intel takes a new step and Huawei got some shades. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with Intel. It looks like their Coffee Lake refresh is getting itself a sort of refresh again. Well, it's not technically a refresh, but the 9th generation CPUs are getting a new stepping. CPU stepping is basically a change or a revision of a CPU there to fix an issue or increase functionality. Sometimes it's even a change in the silicon itself. Usually, those are small alterations that don't do much. These change the number of the stepping, like going from A1 to A2. More complex changes in the stepping of a CPU change the actual letter, like from A1 to B1. In this specific case, ASUS had to roll out a new BIOS update for all the 300 series motherboards to support this new stepping, so it might be like a medium to big change. Stepping could improve power consumption or even overclocking, but unfortunately, we don't have any more details on what the stepping is here since Intel hasn't actually mentioned it. These new Were CPUs are scheduled to launch in Q2 of 2019, so I guess we'll have to wait and see what changed. Just to be clear, the SKUs will stay the same, so we're not getting a brand new series of 9th gen CPUs, just a sort of refresh. If they're doing that now, it might mean that the 9th gen will probably stick around for longer than we thought, even past Ryzen's 3rd generation. And maybe the 10-core Comet Lake that we've been hearing about might be a standalone product. Or maybe we'll have two of them, one 10-core with hyper-threading and one without. Hey Intel, please don't do that. Moving on to smartphone news, Huawei just announced the P30 and P30 Pro. Not like it matters because it got leaked pretty much everywhere before their announcement, but at least it's here. It's a good old flagship phone with their Kirin 980 chip, 6GB of RAM, a nice beefy battery with a 40-watt charger. Which isn't bad, but we've seen better, more on that later. And the P30 Pro features a 5x periscope camera zoom. Besides the phone, they also unveiled a new pair of headphones called the Freelace. They look like the average pair of headphones, but the cool thing is that you can actually charge them by connecting them into the phone. I like the concept, but I hate the style of headphones. And lastly, during the event, they revealed that they are working on smart glasses. At least this isn't a Google Glass or a Snapchat spectacle situation. It's basically like an old-school one-eared Bluetooth device that fits into the frame of the glasses. No cameras wanted or needed. They look pretty cool, but I mean, really? Smart glasses? Now, in case you didn't know, a video has surfaced of a new Xiaomi charger. Now, this isn't just any charger. It got a phone with a 4000 mAh battery up to 100% charged in 17 minutes. This is ridiculous. The video was posted on the Weibo account of the general manager of Redmi. Apparently, the charger is 100 watts, which is double the power of the fastest charger currently on the market, built by Oppo at 50 watts. I just thought it was fascinating. We went from having to charge our phones for 2 hours plus with a 2000 mAh battery to now 17 minutes for a 4000 mAh one. I honestly just hope that more companies will adopt those kind of fast charging system because having to plug in your phone for like a few minutes for it to get all the way to full charge or close to is a world in which I want to live in. Just don't make it explode in my pocket, please. Then in Canadian news, it looks like Fido, that's one of our cell phone service provider here, has decided that a $10 fee to communicate with them is a good idea. Basically, if you call in, use live chat or even social media to get some support, you're going to get charged 10 bucks. Okay, it doesn't apply to everything, only things that a user can already do in self-serve, but I mean, you try to explain to my grandma how self-serve works. It would be great if that lowered the cost of the phone plans, but just the opposite. Their prices have actually gone up this month. What about you guys in the rest of the world? Does your cell phone service provider charge you when you call them? Let me know down below. Then in gaming, Bethesda just revealed that its upcoming games will be coming to Steam. Titles like Doom Eternal, Rage 2, and the two new Wolfensteins won't be exclusive to the Bethesda launcher. Now at this point, it's hard to say if that's a move from Steam to keep the titles in its stores, or just Bethesda going for the bigger store in the market. Oh, and also Fallout 76 will be on Steam later this year too, but who cares, really? Actually, I wouldn't mind if it was discounted to oblivion during a Steam sale. I might pick it up then. All right, guys, that is pretty much it for today's news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Leave a like for your boy Snows down below. Keep dropping those comments, by the way. I love them. I read every single one of them. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video right here. To subscribe to the channel, it would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one.